In continuation to my earlier lecture, today we will see some example for the Fourier synthesis. In my previous lectures, I have explained how to synthesize the periodical wave. Just I will highlight the important point here. So in order to synthesize the Fourier wave of periodic function, find the Fourier coefficient a naught, an, and pn. Apply this value into the Fourier synthesis equation. That is, f of x is equal to a naught plus summation of cos term plus summation of sin term. That is the Fourier synthesis equation. I have explained this so many times, so I don't want to highlight about it. And add the sinusoidal wave obtained using the coefficient a naught, an, and pn. Keep on adding till you get desired value. Adding more number of sinusoidal wave will gives you the more accurate waveform that you have desired. We will see how to synthesize the triangular wave using sine wave. Just you look into the picture, I have shown that a triangular wave is shown in in blue color one, and the xy axis is shown in yellow color. I have taken the range between minus pi to plus pi. Normally I will take the range between minus pi to plus pi. In some book, as I told earlier, they will take from 0 to 2 pi or 1 to minus 1 to plus 1. That will not change your result. Similarly, the amplitude, most of the book, they will take minus 1, 2 plus 1 or 0 to 5. Normally, I will take minus pi to plus pi. That the result does not affect your result. Say, for example, in some book, they used to take from 0 to 2 pi instead of minus pi to plus pi. They will take 0 to 2 pi or 0 to pi. That is nothing but a shift. That will be taken care of the factor a naught. That is the Fourier coefficient a naught is called the TC term. That will take care. Normally, I will take the amplitude and period such that the a naught will become 0. For the triangular wave, in some book, you may have seen that a naught value is pi by 2 or pi, something like that. So, nothing wrong in my calculation. That is only the shift factor. Say, for example, instead of minus pi, if I shift my wave pi, plus 5, that it will be equal to 0. If this will start 0 and it will go up to 2.5, and I think more than that. Now I will explain my diagram. I have taken the time period minus 5 to plus 5. Y axis is f of x. So I have taken, see here, from the y axis, both side, if you look into it, you can notice a symmetry. There is a positive slope between minus pi to 0 and a negative slope between 0 to pi. But the value is same. This is an even function. Say, for example, when x is equal to pi, then the f of x is equal to minus pi. When x is equal to minus pi, then also the f of x is equal to minus pi. Similarly, when x is equal to 0, f of x is equal to pi. Here it is interesting to note that when x is equal to pi by 2, then f of x is equal to 0. Whether it is plus pi by 2, it is 0. Minus pi by 2, then also it will be 0. It is a perfectly symmetric one. So the amount will be zero approximately. If we take area of both side, that this integral is nothing but area under this curve, there is a equal area in positive axis and equal area in negative axis, so the total area will become zero. That works, I mean, that the N0 is equal to zero. Now, let us see what is f of x. F of x is the maximum value of f of x is plus pi. So, now here I am going to take, because it is an even function, I am going to take the period between 0 and pi. Between 0 and pi, the maximum value is pi, and it keep on decreasing up to minus pi. So, the slope is dy by dx, that is, y is 2 pi, and x is here, I have taken between 0 to pi, x is pi. So, f of x is equal to pi minus slope into x. This negative sign comes because the value keep on decreasing with respect to x. So, the slope is 2 pi pi pi. So, it will pi pi cancel out, we will get pi minus 2x. Say for example, if x is equal to 0, you will get f of x is equal to pi. And f is equal to pi, then you will get f of x is equal to minus pi. F of x is, if x is equal to pi, f of x is equal to minus pi, and and it will go on. So it is equally a symmetrical one. So both sides it is symmetry. So for example, if f of x is pi by 2, then if x is pi by 2, f of x is equal to 0. Whether it is plus pi by 2 or minus pi by 2, it is f of x is equal to 0. So it is perfectly symmetry on both sides, that is positive x axis and negative x axis. So this can be represented as f of x is equal to pi minus 2x when x is x lies between 0 to pi. And one more thing is, I have already explained, what about to Pn? Pn value is f of x multiplied by sin x. Here sin x is an add function. Even into add, even function multiplied by add function gives you the add function. The integral value of add function between the symmetrical limit will be equal to 0, so Pn also will be 0. Here a0 also 0, the Pn also will be equal to 0. Then we will see what will happen. Now f of x is fixed as is equal to pi minus 2x for the range x is between 0 to pi. Now An can be written as the Fourier coefficient An is equal to 1 over pi integral between minus pi to plus pi f of x cos nx dx. Here both f of x and cos x are the even function, so the product also even function. We know f of x is equal to pi minus 2x. So just you replace that here. We will get, because its limit are symmetrical, I have changed it from minus pi to plus pi into 0 to pi, and I have multiplied this by 2 times 0 to pi. I have changed the limit, which is, and if you integrate, taking the integral pi minus 2x cos nx dx. So this will become pi into cos nx dx minus this 2x is here, 2 plus 2 into 2 will become 4, so 4 divided by 5 integral over 0 to pi x, this x, x cos nx dx. We know very well if you integrate cos x, you will get sin x. So sin 0, sin pi becomes 0, upper limit. If you apply upper limit, lower limit, this will become 0 naturally. So the only the second term left, that is a n is equal to minus 4 divided by pi integral between 0 to pi x cos nx dx. Now we arrived at the expression an is equal to minus 4 over 5 integral 0 to pi x cos nx dx. Here we have to carry out the integration using pi parts. That is, we know very well that integral over u v prime dx is equal to u v minus u prime v dx. Here, prime indicates differential operator. That is, v prime is equal to dv by dx. Similarly, u prime is equal to du by dx. It indicates derivative of v and u respectively. From the above equation, we take x as u. U is equal to x. Then derivative of u is equal to 1. Then similarly, you take the derivative of v, that is v prime, as cos nx. And then naturally, if you integrate it, you will get v. That is equal to v is equal to sin x over n. Sin nx over n, that I have represented in the rectangular box. So you just substitute those values in this equation. So you will get u instead of u, I am using x v prime, I am using cos nx, and v prime I am using cos nx, and v I am using sin nx over n. If you substitute this, you will arrive this expression integral x cos nx dx is equal to x is u v, that is sin nx over n, minus u prime, that is derivative of u, which is equal to 1, into v. V is equal to sin nx over n dx. Now it is important to note that if you apply the limit to 0 to 5, this first term sin 0 also 0, sin pi also 0. Between upper and lower limit, the first term will become 0. So we can eliminate that. And then only the second term remains, that is minus integral sin x nx over x dx between the limit 0 to 5. That is an, we know that an is equal to 4 over 5 integral between the limit 0 to 5 x cos nx dx will be equal to 4 over n pi, because already here one minus, and in the term an there is another minus, that is that scaling factor, that is normalization factor, minus 4 pi over 5, there one minus is there, here another minus, so this will become plus, so this will become 4 over n pi integral between 0 to 5 sin nx dx. So now we got an is equal to 4 over n pi integral over 0 to 5 sign NHTH. So if you substitute the limit for this, if you integrate sin nx, you will get minus cos nx over n. Then you apply the limit between 0 and pi, you will get minus, I have taken this minus out, minus 4 over n squared. Here 1n, already there is 1n. So this will become n squared pi. After applying the limit, you will get cos n pi minus cos 0. Just this will be equal to, you interchange the term in the bracket that cos 0 or minus cos n pi. So this minus will be automatically goes away because we are interchanging the term. So this will become 4 over n squared pi into 1 minus cos n pi. In some books you might have noticed that they used to 4 pi n squared pi squared because they have taken the limit amplitude 1 minus 1 to plus 1. I have taken the amplitude minus pi to plus pi. So that is important, how you are choosing the parameter. But it will not affect your result, I will show it that. Finally we arrived to the expression an is equal to 4 divided by n squared pi 1 minus cos n pi. Now here it is interesting to note that for add value of n you will get minus 1. So this will become 2. So an will become 8 over n squared pi. This is valid only for add number. Otherwise, this an will be 0. So an is a, we have an positive, we have an exists only if n is an add, otherwise it will be 0. Now we will plug into the coefficient what we have obtained in our calculation into the Fourier synthesis equation, that is usually equation f of x is equal to a naught plus summation over cosine term and summation over cos term plus. Now we estimated a naught is equal to 0 and pn also is equal to 0. The remaining term is only the second one, that is summation over 1 to n an cos nx. We have find the an is equal to 8 over pi n squared. N squared I have brought inside because it's a running index. So this is summation over, this will be equal to 8 over pi summation over 1 to n cos n pi over n squared. Where n is an odd number, we have to keep it in mind that it is odd number. In my earlier lecture also I explained that normally I will take this scaling factor as 1. 8 over 5, I have taken this as approximately as 1, or otherwise you can take I have ignored the scaling factor because the scaling factor will come throughout all the cosine wave here. So it is nothing but amplification factor. So just you ignore this, so you will get f of x is equal to summation over 1 to n cos nx over n squared. Here n is an odd number. So finally, we arrived at this expression. Here it is interesting to note that in the case of square wave, it is sin nx pi over n, of course, summation. In that lecture, I explained because the amplitude decreases by 1 over n is slowly converging. So we have seen the square wave is slowly converging one, whereas here you see that f of x is equal to cos x plus cos 3x plus 9, 3 squared is 9 plus cos 5 square is 25 plus cos 7x, 7 square is 49. Similarly, cos 9x, cos 9x is 9 square is 81. So it will go like this. It will decrease very fast. So that means it converts very fast. Now we will see visually how this cosine combination of or superposition of cosine wave is changed into the triangular wave. So just first one shows the first wave cosine wave without any addition of another sine wave. Then I have added one sine wave. So second term looked like this. After adding third term, you can notice it is very closer to, more or less very closer to triangle. Whereas in square wave generation, I have taken so many numbers, even more than 19 sine wave. Here within third cosine wave, I got this thing. This is due to the nature that 1 over n squared wave. This it converges very fast. Now just you see after adding a seventh term, it's almost like a triangular wave. That is cosine wave become square triangular wave after adding seven cosine term of a different frequency and with a different amplitude. That different amplitude also important parameter here because it converges fast, unlike square wave where it is slowly decaying one, because the amplitude reduces 1 over n times. Here 1 over n square time, that is the reason why it is reducing, it is converging very fast. In the next class, we will see about the sawtooth wave. Thank you very much for watching my videos.